Hello everyone, I welcome you all to Geeky Syntax. Today I am going to show you how to install IntelliJ IDEA on a Windows operating system. And after that, I am also going to show you how you can easily run a simple Hello World Java program on one IntelliJ IDEA. So for that, first you need to go to your favorite browser. I am going to Google Chrome, and here I am going to search IntelliJ IDEA download and hit enter. And when you do that, it's going to show you this download IntelliJ IDEA. You need to just simply open that link and it's going to redirect to the official site of JetBrains. So here you can see that our IntelliJ IDEA ultimate version is available, but we are not going to download the ultimate version. What we are going to do is we are going to download the community one. Alright, so you need to scroll down in order to get to the community edition, and you need to click on this download button. So when you click on download button, it's going to show you like thank you for downloading IntelliJ IDEA, and it's going to start downloading our IntelliJ IDEA. I have already downloaded it, so I'll just simply close this. I'll minimize my browser. I'll go to my download directory, and here you can see that we already have IntelliJ IDEA downloaded locally on our system. So let's double click on the installer, and it's going to ask you for administrative privileges. Just simply click on yes. So welcome to IntelliJ IDEA setup. So let's first minimize our download directory. So here you need to just simply click on next. So this is where our IntelliJ IDEA is going to be installed. It's totally fine. Just simply click on next. And now under installation options, they have given some check boxes, right? So from here, this is very important. You need to check this add bin folder to path. So what's going to happen is it's going to set our, you know, this path, bin folder path in our environment variable. All right. So that's a very important step. And also you can see that it is telling that it will require restart of our system, right? So I'm going to show you at what point you need to restart. So don't worry. So just, you know, simply keep watching this video. All right. And you need to also check this IntelliJ IDEA community edition. So that it's going to create a desktop shortcut. So just right below Google Chrome, once our installation gets complete, it's going to create a desktop shortcut. So similarly, here you need to also check this add open folder as project. So what happens is, so let's say you have a project lying over here, all right? So, and that's a folder type. So when you right click on that, here additionally this option open folder as project option going to be showing over there. All right, so that's why it is important to check this option as well. And now I'm selecting Java. If you are also want to code it in Kotlin, you can select Kotlin, and all these different languages like Gradle, Groovy and all that totally depend upon your uses. For now I'll select only Java. I'll also uncheck Kotlin, not a problem. You can select any of these options. You can select all the options as well. All right, so just simply click on next after that, and it's going to create a JetBrains folder, which is also totally fine. Just simply click on install, and there you go. You can see our installation is rightly began. So here also you can see that desktop shortcut is created, right? Version 2023, that version 2023.3.2. So you know, this will take some time. You can see it is extracting the file, and it parallelly installing it, so it takes time. So once we are done with this, I'm going to again coming back to this video. So welcome back, and now you can see that it is telling that completing IntelliJ IDEA community edition setup. So our installation is almost done. So as I have told you that time that it is important to reboot your system, so this is the time. So you need to, you know, click on this reboot now and click on finish. So what it will do, it will going to automatically restart your system, and it's going to again, you know, let you log in. So for that, let's restart our system and then again come back to this video. So after successfully rebooting your system, you'll be again landed over to the desktop. So you need to simply click on the shortcut, IntelliJ IDEA community shortcut, launch it. So if you haven't installed IntelliJ IDEA previously, so you need to select this do not import settings, click on OK. And welcome to IntelliJ IDEA. So let's maximize this, and here let's, you know, click on this new project. So we are going to create a new project, and we are going to show you how we can easily, you know, run our Java program. So I'm going to give the project name as Hello World, and here you can see that our SDK is not, you know, SDK portion, it is telling that no SDK. So it is important to have Java installed, right? So for that, you click on this drop down and you click on download JDK. So when you click on that, it's going to show you the version that you're going to download. So you can see that if you click on this link, you can see that we have this many options, right? If you want to install Java 17, you can do that. If you want to install Java 18, you can do that. But I'm going to choose the default one, which is, you know, Oracle Open JDK, which is version 21.0.1, latest version as well. So just, you know, simply click on download button and it's going to start fetching the JDK from internet and going to install it automatically on our system. So let's do that. It will take, you know, some time, couple of minutes maybe. So after that, I'm going to again come back to this video. So now you can see that our Java is, you know, rightly installed and it is, you know, properly selected the latest version, which is JDK 21. And that I have done because I have selected Java. If you had selected Kotlin, again, when you switch to Kotlin, you can see that it is telling no, you know, Kotlin JDK found. So you need to again do the same process if you are into Kotlin. Right, I'll go back to Java. So Java JDK is downloaded now. I'll just, you know, simply click on create to create our project, and you can see that our project is created. Let's maximize our IntelliJ IDEA, and you can see that our, you know, main.java file is also created over here. So what they're going to do is they're going to print hello and welcome, and they're going to print this, you know, number from I like 1 to 5, right? So from 1 to 5 it's going to print. Before that, it's going to also print hello, welcome. So, you know, let's wait for some time that it is, you know, currently indexing our JDK. So once we are done with that, you're going to see this run button enabled. And you can see that we are done with indexing. So let's click on the run button and it's going to start building our project. And once it gets successfully builded, it's going to show you the output hello and welcome, and then that number from 1 to 5, right? So in this way, you can easily install latest version of IntelliJ IDEA on a Windows operating system. So that's basically all about this video. I have also started one blogging channel. So if you're interested, you can always subscribe Geeky Script blogging channel. So recently I was in Kashmir. So I have put one short video about Dal Lake. So if you're interested, you can always watch this video and you can subscribe our Geeky Script blogging channel. So that will help you to know where I'm going and all that. All right, so yeah, that's basically all about this video. Thank you very much for watching this video. Please do like, share and subscribe. That will really help me to make more such videos. Thank you very much for watching this video, and God bless you all.